Hey guys, Dr. Jess, and today let's talk about food allergies or intolerances and why they happen. So this is a pretty hot topic right now. People are finding out they're more and more intolerant to certain food groups that are really, really processed, and some of us unfortunately are even allergic or intolerant to foods that we shouldn't be. This happens a lot of times because people have impaired digestive enzyme formation. So they have problems breaking down carbs, sometimes they'll have problems breaking down proteins. Oftentimes people have issues with histamine-containing foods like dairy or wine. And other times people have overt celiac disease where they can't tolerate any gluten at all, or a gluten intolerance. So there are kind of gray areas to whether people are allergic or intolerant. And medicine looks at a food allergy as IgE mediated, which is a certain type of antibody. So remember, our immune systems are overzealous, and again, they're overzealous and overactive against certain foods that they recognize as inflammatory or foreign at this point. So if you have an overt allergy, your mast cells will recognize it, immediately release IgE, and that causes anaphylaxis. So that's a true food allergy where the throat swells up, the blood pressure drops, everything swells up, and you really feel like you're going to pass out and not be able to breathe. That's a true food allergy. Food intolerances are IgG mediated, a different type of antibody, but your body is still mounting a response improperly. And some of those symptoms include malaise, headache, bloating after every meal, nausea, sometimes diarrhea or constipation as well, and it almost looks like an irritable bowel syndrome type of picture. So there are a lot of different ways to treat this. To treat this, a lot of times digestive enzymes or bitters are necessary, which help to trigger your own digestive enzyme formation. Other things that are useful, if there aren't SIBO or small intestinal bacterial overgrowth, you may want to try a probiotic. Chew your food carefully 30 to 40 times each bite, and don't eat when you're upset, you're driving, you're in front of the TV. Eat mindfully with each bite. You also want to cut out things that are inflammatory, things like gluten and dairy, eggs, you know. I also think leaky gut plays a big part of this role, guys. So if you suspect that you have leaky gut, everything you put in there is going to be inflamed and irritated. So really look at healing the gut, really look at enzymes, probiotics, some nice supportive measures. You don't have to have complete oral intolerances or food allergies. Finally, and probably most important, guys, this is just a general roadmap for how to look at allergies and help yourself heal them. It's really important to find a healthcare practitioner that you trust, that is well versed in food allergies and intolerances, because you don't have to feel this way. You don't have to go on eating foods that upset your stomach and make you feel terrible. So thanks for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this. Stay tuned. Next time we'll talk about how to prevent allergies in the growing generation and in children, so that they can prevent allergies and asthma into adulthood.